Tournament performance is the single most important thing for a Smash player trying to be successful, which is one of the reasons why being nervous or losing focus during a set can be so frustrating. Trust me, I've been there. So I set out to do some research on reducing nervousness and improving focus in stressful settings, which tournaments definitely are, and found some psychological tricks which have helped me a lot this far. All these tricks and techniques are scientifically proven to have an effect, so I'm sure you're gonna find at least one helpful improvement for you, no matter if you're a beginner or already a pro player. Let's go! I'm gonna start right off with the most powerful technique: setting your own pre-match routines and conditionings. Conditioning is a powerful tool to combat nervousness and stage fright. Successful athletes often have some kind of routine they go through before every match or important moment, like a basketballer bouncing the ball exactly 3 times before making a shot every time. The reason they do this is to put them in a familiar state of mind in which they can concentrate, stay calm and focus on what they are doing. The idea behind it is very simple. Whenever you feel like you can concentrate easily, when you are calm, precise or when you are in the zone, you do one specific physical action. You do this every time you are in the zone, for example after a long session with your practice partner, until it becomes a habit. If you now are in a tournament setting and you feel you're getting nervous and your hands start to sweat, then you repeat this action. This will make your brain think, oh, he's doing that thing again. That thing he does whenever he can concentrate so well. I guess we are in that kind of situation now. And bam, you are in the zone. Of course, this is the ideal example and it won't be that easy and consistent. During a game, you also usually don't have the time to stand up, squat 2 times and clap your hands as a conditioning stimulus, but there are still very effective things you can do. You could crack your knuckles, rub your knees or, my favorite, simply take a very deep and conscious breath. Whenever I start getting nervous, for example when my opponent gets the first stock or when I misinput something and die for it, I take a very deep breath and get back into the calm and concentrated mindset I have after a good practice session. Try to experiment what kind of routine fits you and when you can feel like you can really get into the zone. Speaking of taking deep breaths, breathing and breathing techniques are a powerful ally when it comes to combating nervousness and staying focused. Published in 2015, Ravinder Jareth and colleagues wrote an article about the treatment of anxiety by teaching patients different breathing techniques. Breathing can have various neuropsychological effects. For example, faster breathing cycles induce a sympathetic response, making you more alert and boosting your stress tolerance. Perfect for when you didn't get enough sleep and can't seem to stay focused. Slow breathing cycles, on the other hand, lower your heart rate and anxiety levels, helping you to calm down when nervousness takes over. There are even techniques like alternating your breath between your nostrils, which, as shown in a study from 2007, improves concentration. I do have to mention though, before you try any of this excessively, and before you start to hyperventilate, because Gaggle said so, do some research for yourself and find what you want to try doing. Explaining all the details of different techniques which might or might not be proven to work would be way too much for this video, so take some time to figure out what's best for you yourself. Personally, I use a cycle of 4 deep and slow breaths, as mentioned in the pre-match routines part, to calm myself down and get into the zone. If you're interested in that, I'm gonna link some articles about the 4-7-8 breathing technique in the description. Drinking water. Now, I know you hear this a lot, water's good for you, you should drink more water, all that stuff. But that's not all there is to it, so hear me out. One of the more well-known facts is that dehydration correlates negatively with attention. In other words, if you're dehydrated, it'll be harder to concentrate. Other studies, for example at the University of London, have found out that short-term memory and working memory are also influenced by dehydration. Okay, you might say, I'll make sure I drink enough water before every tournament. And that's a good idea, but we can take it even further. A study published in the Psychological Research Journal in 2019 measured not only the effects of dehydration, but also effects of immediate water consumption right before a task involving decision-making and judgment. And surprisingly, the subject group who drank a full cup of water right beforehand performed significantly better in those tasks. Of course, this doesn't mean you have to drink liters of water before every set, asking your opponent for a bathroom break after every game would be kind of awkward, but taking just a sip before and after a match can make quite the difference for your performance. Confidence in self-fulfilling prophecies. The psychological phenomenon of the self-fulfilling prophecy describes how being convinced that something will happen will end up being the reason said thing happens. That sounds a bit complicated, but for Smash it simply means, if you think you are going to lose, you will lose. And this isn't just a fancy way of saying, you need to have more confidence. It's a well-studied psychological finding with many factors influencing it. Having a losing mindset has a lot of consequences for your actions during and after a game. For example, if you lose your first stock before your opponent, you might think, yeah, he's just the better player, that was to be expected. You forget about it and go to the next stock. But maybe your opponent just found a lucky combo starter. Maybe you just had the wrong DI and could have avoided it next time if you had thought about it some more. Even worse, if you think, oh, I'm just the worst player, you will use that as an excuse to lose to that person all the time. Instead, you could be thinking, for the next time, I'll have to practice that matchup even more and review my VODs against this player. Same goes for why believing in your character is so important. My character just can't win this matchup. I can't do anything because I play a low tier. You stop thinking about finding new options and things you could do with your character. By the way, thinking that you definitely will win a match can be just as detrimental as thinking you will lose. There are a lot of things we can trick our brain into thinking, but if you're convinced that the next opponent is an easy win just to lose game one, well, your theory of getting an easy win is kinda wrong, and your mentality will take quite a hit. Instead, the mentality you should have is, I can win this match. When you're down a stock, you can still turn it around. When you're faced with the local PR plays one, you can make an upset. Everything is possible. That doesn't mean it will happen, but it certainly could. And that will give you the confidence to keep trying and keep improving. Congratulations, you followed all the tips I gave you and you managed to stay calm until the match starts. You have a good feeling about yourself. You're confident you can win. But then, you get absolutely destroyed, heart red, and lose your first stock to a 0-2 death. Okay, not the perfect start, but remember, everyone can make a comeback. If they got a 0-2 death on you, why can't you also do that, right? But nevertheless, your mind starts racing. You're able to stay calm by taking a deep breath, but you can't seem to concentrate anymore. Your mind is going blank, you start to go for panic options and try to get back in the lead as fast as possible. To put it in fancy neuropsychological terms, your prefrontal cortex shuts down as a natural response to stress and leaves the decision-making to other brain structures like the amygdala. Your prefrontal cortex usually has the job of solving problems, so losing that ability while performing a complex mental task is kind of not so good. The amygdala, on the other hand, decides based on emotions and reflexes. 40,000 years ago, when humans came under stress by facing saber-toothed tigers, it was usually better to listen to your emotions and start running as quickly as possible instead of pondering your life decisions. But in Smash, going for your first emotional response is usually not a good idea. Because that would be something like, oh my god, I need to kill that guy as fast as possible, which results in you fishing for kills by going for way too many Smash attacks and high commitment moves. But there's a way to prevent that. And that's to think of solutions before you even come into a situation where you might need them. If you already have a plan, you can stick to that, take your time, calm down, and then start thinking of new stuff again. During that restart time, however, that time you need to get your prefrontal cortex back up, you have something to rely on. So before the match, think of a game plan, stick to it, and use it whenever you have to. That way, no sudden in-game panic attack can get you. And that's 5 psychological tricks to help you improve your tournament performance. Did you learn something? If you did, then consider leaving a like and telling me which of these was the most helpful to you. I always try to improve my content, so I appreciate all and every feedback. Until the next video.